I'll admit, guys, I didn't expect the Bulls to win this one, not only because the Heat are a good team and the Bulls don't do that great against teams above 500, as we know, but also because the Bulls just don't match up well against a team like the Heat, a team that has a strong defensive center, a good defensive team in general, but then they also have sharpshooters on offense like Duncan Robinson, Tyler Hero, although he was out tonight, and Kendrick Nunn. And of course, the Bulls aren't a good perimeter defending team. Well, really, they struggle on defense in general. And what initially looked like a game that I almost considered just turning off based on how slow of a start the Bulls came out with this game, really for that whole first half anyway, but then the Bulls chipped away at the lead steadily in the third, and the Bulls actually ended up being down 17 at the end of the third, I believe it was, and I knew that this game was all but over. But then I made this comment in the live chat, knowing that if somehow the Bulls were able to come back in the fourth quarter in this game, that it would be a game changer for them for the rest of the season and closing out the remaining schedule. And you could see my follow-up comment, I just didn't even know why I said that, but the Bulls actually played an incredible fourth quarter. And if it wasn't for Denzel freaking Valentine thinking that he's Steph Curry out there, the Bulls might have done the unthinkable and pulled out a win in this one. So what's going on, everyone? You're listening to Bulls Central here. Hope you're all doing well. I think there are a few things we can take away from this game. Well, one, the Bulls have to come out strong. They can't fall early in games like they have a lot this season because it's hard to dig yourself out of a hole like that. You can't come up flat on a team that just played last night when you were off the night before. Come out strong and take an early lead. The other thing, Bulls have to not rely so much on their threes, especially when those shots aren't going in. The Bulls actually are a decent offensive team in the paint, mainly because of Vucevic, but also you have guys like Tice, Thaddeus Young, who are decent at posting up, Patrick Williams, who's a good mid-range shooter, and Coby White, who is also a solid slasher to the hoop. They don't always need to settle for outside shots when you actually have weapons who can score inside. And that even goes for Lavine, you know, when he's in the lineup anyway. He's incredibly quick and smooth at driving to the hoop, so stop chucking up threes and set up good plays and go inside. And then finally, the main takeaway from this game, stop playing Denzel Valentine in the clutch. And actually, scratch that, stop playing Denzel, period. I know there are, you know, some things that Denzel does well, and obviously he can get hot from outside, and he can do it when you need a big shot from him, but his self-awareness and overall IQ and decision making on the court is so piss poor sometimes that it boggles my mind that Billy Donovan keeps giving him as many minutes as he gets. I know Trey Brown Jr. is out, so you would likely have to think that Valentine would be getting less minutes as a result if Brown was actually in fact playing. But even when Brown was in the lineup, Denzel was still getting decent minutes, taking minutes away from a key defender, a young player who has been playing very well since being traded to the Bulls. And I know there are a few big time Denzel fans out there who are probably going to rip me in the comments on this video saying, well, Denzel was playing well and that's why Billy Donovan left him in. And he was great on defense. He had 3 steals and 2 blocks tonight, and he hit 3 3-pointers. Great. Did you miss the play where he chucked up a 3 from near half court in transition with no rebounders under the basket after the Bulls had crawled their way back into this game and were only down by 4 points? In what world is that ever a good decision? I honestly don't think someone like Steph Curry would have even taken that shot. And it's not like a, oh, well, you know, rookie mistake, he's still learning. No, Denzel is 27 years old and he's in his 5th season in the league. Like Stacey King, you know, which granted both Stacey King and Adam Amin were dumbfounded when Denzel took that shot even after he released it. But later on, Stacey was saying that Garrett Temple is having a conversation, a veteran to a young player, on, you know, needing to make better decisions in those type of moments. And I don't agree with that at all. Denzel has been in the league for a while now, and he was a 4-year college player. These aren't rookie mistakes. You know, and rookies don't even make these type of mistakes, okay? And look, at the end of the day, you know, maybe it wouldn't have mattered and the Bulls would have lost anyway, even if they had gotten a better possession on that play and in fact scored. But the fact of the matter is, the Bulls had a shot at winning this game, and that play, which led to the Heat converting on the other end, could have been the difference maker in this game. And guys, it's different if this was like, you know, a second or a third week into the season, you know, mistakes are made early on and they don't really impact a team's standings overall, but not when you have 13 games, now 12, left on the schedule and every possession counts at this point for you to have that kind of shot that you need in order to get to the playoffs. The Raptors did lose tonight, which is a plus, but the Pacers won, and again, the Wizards are on a roll, and they have a much easier schedule than the Bulls do going down the stretch. And then what was even more insane to me, after Denzel took that extremely ill-advised shot, probably one of the worst shots that I've seen from any player all season, he comes back and fouls the scorer on the other end for an and one, and then somehow Billy Donovan decides to keep him in the game to close things out. I was just beside myself. Like, I get that it's very common for coaches to roll with the guys on the court who are going on an incredible run. But after you see one of your guys make a play like that and all but end the game for your team, you take them out of the lineup, more so as a message or a lesson that you can't be making those type of plays. I mean, if I made a boneheaded play like that when I used to play in school, I knew I was going to be getting taken out, no matter how well I did before. I don't know, I really don't understand it, and I think, you know, I'll lose my mind if somehow this front office decides to extend Valentine this offseason after his contract expires. But anyway, enough about Valentine, because, you know, Denzel seems like a very nice dude, and so I don't want to rip into him that much. I just can't stand his game, and I really wish he would get less minutes. But what I will say about this game, though, in general, was that, you know, this almost went from a very embarrassing loss based on how things were trending to a turnaround that you had to be pleased to see if you're a Bulls fan, and how they showed up in the second half, playing hustle defense, moving the ball well, taking better shots and actually hitting their shots. And there was more of a sense of urgency. And the Heat, because they played last night, they started looking a little gassed, and the Bulls took advantage of it. Now, for Vucevic, who had a great game, another double-double, but he had two crucial turnovers there late in the game that led to Heat buckets. And you just have to take better care of the ball when you know Jimmy is on the court, one of the best pickpocketers in the game. He did finish the game with 26 points, 14 rebounds, and 6 assists on very efficient shooting, 11 for 18, although not the best from three. Vucevic only shot 2 for 6 from deep. And Coby White, man, another solid game for him. Maybe not so much on the first half. He started off pretty slow, but the second half, he was huge in getting the Bulls back into this game. He did have 6 turnovers, and some of those were pretty bad, especially early on, which led to a lot of converted possessions for the Heat. But for the game, 31 points, 5 rebounds, and 5 assists, and 2 steals on great efficiency, very similar to Vuce. He shot 11 for 18 from the floor. Took a little too many threes, more than I would have liked to have seen, but as long as we keep seeing Coby play the way that he has recently, rather than what we were seeing just a few weeks ago, I'll take it. Another very poor 3-point shooting night for the Bulls, who shot 13 for 38 at 34%, and yet again, another 17 turnovers in this game, which is just unacceptable, especially this late in the season. Just game after game, high turnovers from this team, and it has been the cause of so many losses this year, and a lot of unforced turnovers throughout the season as well. So that's what makes it even more frustrating as a fan. And I mean, you look at the Heat's box score, and you see that there are 4 starters all scoring 20 or more points. And for the Bulls, you have P. Will scoring 4 points. Garrett Temple only had 2. He had a really rough night offensively, shooting 1 for 7 from the field. And Tice with 9 points. It's just hard for the Bulls to be an overall well-rounded team compared to what you see from some of the best teams in the league. Anyway, it was a disappointing loss, mainly because the Bulls could have made an incredible comeback to win this one and really set the tone for their confidence and momentum going into these final 12 games of the year, but poor decisions and getting off to a very slow start prevented that from happening tonight. But I will say, it was better that the Bulls, you know, rather than them just completely folding and calling it quits like we have seen in a few games this year where they, you know, have just fallen down early, the Bulls came back and made a decent run and actually made the game entertaining and interesting. The Bulls will be off tomorrow and will then take on the Heat again on Monday. Hopefully the Bulls will at least take some of that confidence they had in getting back into this game and use that as fire to not let the Heat get out and in front of them early and take care of business and splitting the pair of these two games. But anyway, I'll be back with another video tomorrow, and then my Bulls weekly preview video on Monday, so be sure to be on the lookout for that. As always, be sure to subscribe as I post daily Bulls content. Thanks again for tuning in, guys, and I will catch you in the next one.